welcome to the pre-show. That's right, we do pre-shows here. Basically, it's me with my camera off as I do everything. Oh, hi! Welcome, everybody. Hope everyone is well. We've got a few people in the chat already, which is fantastic. See Squat over on twitch.tv/505games. What's up? K-Paul Anorad on YouTube says, oi, I'll oi you, sir. Thank you very much. Ollie and Wobbly Redman over on the twitch.tv/505games. Guys, it's great to have you in. Welcome, 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 one and all. Oh, and we got a bit of a good time for you guys. So, welcome to the pre-show, everybody. We'll do full-on intros later as we go along, because that's just how nicely and kindly we are operating today. And to be honest, it's usually just me sitting here pressing buttons and making sure everything worked before I show you my face as I cry. Welcome to live video production, folks. Hope everyone is well. Chat, can you let me know what the audio is like, if that is all right with everyone? I'm sure it's okay. He's got, oh, don't cry! I am going to cry. It is, it's been, that's a promise. That is a James. C-Squats in the chat says, game audio is quite loud. Thank you very much, Squats. Give me a second. I'm just going to quickly drop that down just a tad. Hopefully it's not too bad. Or I just need to actually speak up. Game down, James. Up. I can gear up. I can be very up. Don't you worry about that. Give me a second. Advanced audio properties. That's not what I wanted to do. I did want to just... And some gain to my voice. Add some gain to my voice. There we go. Hopefully that should be all right. I'm going to quickly just drop me up just a little bit more again. There we go. This is the thing. We're currently on the title screen, so it's not as it's just not as, like, it's dominating at the moment. But I'm telling you, it's going to get loud, folks. It's going to get loud. In the chat, still on the starting soon screen. I know. Game audio could still come down a tad. We can't see your face. I know, SK. I know. Welcome to the pre-show, where we don't have my face on, as I, at this point, fiddle around with faders to make sure that all the audio is live. And I'm telling you now, we're going to end up kind of meddling it throughout the stream as well, because that is just how that goes. Anyway, folks, enough about the audio issues. I want to know about you. What is everyone's days like? Is everyone all good? I hope you are all good. We're just going to wait a couple more minutes before we get into the game. Ooh, that was a very satisfying can crack. I probably should have timed that better. Never mind. Oh, well. welcome in, one and all. Welcome to the pre-show. We're going to be playing some Miasma Chronicles today. I bet you can't wait for all that. I'm just getting told in the by my colleagues in the window that we can't see your face. I know, that's the whole point of a pre-show, everybody. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. We're going there. We're getting there. We're getting to the actual show. This is the show before the show. You know, you're getting at this point, you're getting a free radio show, really. I've just been shouted at. Fun fact, actually, as I was testing the mic whilst I was doing all this, C-Squad's James is powdering his nose. Literally, I am making sure that I look pretty before any camera goes on, let's be bluntly honest. As I was testing all the equipment and testing my microphone, just making sure everything is as it should do, I screamed down in the whole office. And I got some very concerned colleagues. It was rather funny. Anyway, okie dokie, folks. Shall we get on with the show? Chat, what we all thinking? I think we should. But I want confirmation. I want confirmation. Butternut Sloth knows exactly what this is. Dramatic face reveal, building the tension. Exactly. You see? This is how this goes, folks. This is how this goes. You do a bit of a pre-show. It's like when you're watching, before your programs start on like terrestrial TV. I know no one watches terrestrial TV nowadays, but before your program starts, you end up getting that little announcer that's just having a cheeky fun before the program actually starts, and then you roll into the credits. That's exactly what this is. Exactly what this is. Anyway, let me show you my face. Hi! It wasn't that dramatic build-up, was it? I'm sure it wasn't. Coming up on BBC iPlayer. Exactly, C-Squads. That is how that goes. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, everybody around the world, welcome to twitch.tv/505games and youtube.com/505games. Yes, we are live on both of those channels today. And more importantly, this week, we are playing some Miasma Chronicles. I know what you're thinking. James, you've been yawning on about Miasma Chronicles for a very long time. Why do we have to see this all over again? Well, let me tell you, person who is also thinking that, the reason why I'm telling you is we have launched. Miasma Chronicles is now out in the world, and we are here to celebrate with you. That's right, you, the community, because let me flippin' tell you, I am excited. I'm so excited to get this game out. It's so great to actually get your thoughts, get your reviews out on it, and get people's thoughts and emotions going into this game, because this is a game you need to play, everybody. It really is. We'll get into the whole rigmarole of why we're doing this and playing Miasma Chronicles in just a moment. But before I go any further, of course, welcome to 505 Games Plays. My name is James. I am a brand community manager here at 505 Games. And I look after lots of titles, including Miasma Chronicles. We are live playing Miasma Chronicles every Friday throughout June. So make sure that you write down in your little schedules as to when you'll see my face, but also when you'll be getting involved in lots of the streams that we've actually got planned throughout June. So every Friday at 3 p.m. BST, so UK time for those people who aren't entirely sure what that means. 3 p.m. UK time, which I think is 4 p.m. European, and I think it's 7 a.m. For the West Coast, of course. Then make sure that you note those down, because we will be live. It is a burp shirt. I do like my burps. They're very nice burps. Thank you very much. And Gatoby from is right here from Germany. Oh, my word. What's up, my friend? It is good to have you in the chat. It is great to see you. I hope you are well. Amphi Squid is also in the chat over on Twitch. Thank you very much. It's always always good to have a good thumbs up, you know what I'm saying? Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, Miasma Chronicles has launched. Yes, it is out in the wild now. It is out now on PS5, Xbox Series X and S, Steam, Epic, and GOG. So first and foremost, I want to give a massive round of applause. I'm probably a little quieter so you can actually hear me. To everybody who has been involved within that project, from the bearded ladies, the guys over in Malmo in Sweden. Thank you ever so much for having, first and foremost, the patience to deal with me. But more importantly, creating an absolute masterpiece. Thank you very much. Well done, guys. You've done a huge job. Everyone over here at 505 Games, congratulations, guys. Really, congratulations. Everyone has done an amazing job getting this game out and through the door, and it's down to literally every single person here at 505, whether or not you are Big Ron in the cupboard doing all the IT stuff, to Fran over at NQA. You have been an absolute dream to work with, so thank you very much for helping us get this off the ground and into people's hands. And more importantly, thank you to the players. Without you guys, we certainly wouldn't be creating any games, of course, but more importantly, you guys have really really knocked it out of the park. The reviews have been amazing. The feedback has been absolutely wonderful. If you've not seen any of the reviews for Miasma Chronicles, you need to check them out. It is doing astronomically well, and we are very, very proud that, to see that people are enjoying the game how we intended to make it. An absolutely stunning game about two brothers on a journey of discovery. It is it's incredible. So again, huge congratulations to everyone, including the community. And one thing I do want to give a massive thank you and shout out to is our virtual photography friends. Oh my goodness me, the shots you guys have been creating are fantastic. The teams love them, and it is certainly something that we want to celebrate and shout out. So if you are a virtual photographer, please get in touch with us, and we will make sure to celebrate your work alongside everyone else's in the next coming weeks. Yeah, guys, thank you. This has been an amazing project to work on, and I'm absolutely stoked to see the response. It's been awesome. Anyway, the chat, thank you ever so much. It really has been a work of art to get this done and out and into your hands. But we're not done yet. We have seen, of course, many people in the Steam forums and, of course, online mention and kind of report bugs to us. Thank you ever so much for everyone who has done and reported some of the little bugs that we've found over the past week. We really do appreciate you. Just to kind of give everyone a bit of a heads up, from last week, it was from this week, we began to start rolling out updates addressing a lot of your feedback and some of the concerns that even reviewers had some issues with. So please be patient whilst we do that. They are coming thick and fast, and as soon as we get more information, we'll be able to pass them down to you. But lo and behold, we've actually addressed quite a lot of what has been reported. So be keep your eyes out early next week for some further updates from us. I've got a bit of a tickle in my throat there. It has been an amazing week. We've also got updates coming out throughout June as well. Get that looked at. I really should, Fran. So this month is going to be a very busy week, very busy month for Miasma Chronicles. Next week, physical editions of Miasma Chronicles will hit shelves in Europe. That's right, June 9th, you will be able to get your physical copy of Miasma Chronicles. So, of course, we'll be celebrating for that. And more importantly, is equally as important, June 20th, you'll be able to get physical editions over in North America. So make sure that you keep an eye on your local retailers, as they'll be able to provide you all the information that you need. So alongside celebrating all those launches and doing our weekly streams, I'm also hoping that we can do a bit of a board game stream. Yes, that is right. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a board game for Miasma Chronicles. It is not available publicly. It will not be available publicly. It is something that we kind of created as a one-off little thing. However, what we will be doing is we will be doing some board game streams throughout June. So again, more information to come when I lock them all down. But also, we will be doing some giveaways on the board game as well. So make sure that you keep an eye on the 505 Games local accounts, wherever you are in the world, as well as 505 Games UK. And of course, Miasma Chronicles, all over social media. We will give you the information that you need to know if you want to win one of these. Just to kind of give you a bit of a heads up as to what it is. So it's kind of classed as what's called an escape room board game. So effectively, you are are tasked to, I believe it's find someone who's been missing from sedentary. It is 18 plus, it is 1 to 2 players, and can probably take about 90 minutes. So it's a pretty decent board game, actually. This one's also sealed, by the way. I know, it's really sealed. Either way, this could be yours. Stick around over the next couple of weeks, and we will be getting that as soon as possible, I promise. Gatobi in the chat. MC will be better than Jagged Alliance 3, I'm convinced. Well, if Gatobi's convinced, then I equally am convinced. Thank you ever so much, mate. It's been an absolute pleasure. And thank you ever so much for your contribution towards the Discord and obviously on social media. We really do appreciate it. Thank you ever so much, guys. Right, I've been talking for nigh on about 20 minutes now, and I'm sure everyone's bored of me. So, what we are planning to do is begin our definitive playthrough of Miasma Chronicles. That is right. We have to start again. I'm sorry, folks. I'm really, really sorry. So the reason why is the last streams, the early look streams that we did, you may have noticed that they were what we would call beta branches, and particular test builds that we could actually use to skip forward and kind of add some additional things that you probably shouldn't have received to begin with, etc., etc., etc. And unfortunately, the big old bosses over at the Bearded Ladies and 505 Games said no, James, you must start it again from the beginning. And I said fine, I will. So that's exactly what we're going to be doing today. We're going to be starting our definitive playthrough, and we are going to be playing this over the next coming weeks until its very end. And then it's entirely up to you guys as to whether or not you want to see something else, do something else. So, see squads in the chat says, to be fair, the start of the game is super cool. Exactly, who doesn't want to see the start of the game yet? And you're also going to literally see me play it as I would normally and naturally play things as well. So nothing too over the top, nothing too... I want to do an actual casual playthrough, you know what I mean? So what I'm going to do is we are going to... Well, actually, I want to just quickly reiterate what we are going to be doing. So for the uninitiated, if you are just tuning in for the very first time, Miasma Chronicles is a TRPG, a tactical RPG. So it's kind of a tactical turn-based RPG, as we kind of call it. And effectively, it is strongly a very tactical game, really. We've seen a lot of people compare it to XCOM. We've seen a lot of people compare it, of course, to the previous Bearded Ladies game, Mutant Year Zero. And it's kind of a little bit of a mashup of the two, slash with Gears Tactics and lots of other things in between. It's its own little entity. Miasma Chronicles is more than just a hard-ass tactical game, but it is quite challenging. Now, we have actually seen a few people ask us about the alpha editor mode over on the community. We are aware of a couple of a very small number of the community having some issues with alpha editor, and don't worry, we are on it. They are looking to be addressed very, very soon, as I mentioned in those upcoming patches. So please, we have been listening. We do listen. Every single bit of feedback I have personally written down in my notebook, and I have showed it to the Bearded Ladies, and they'd said, yep, okay, and there you go. So that's how that works. If it wasn't for you guys, we wouldn't have remapped the WASD keys, the WASD keys. So again, see, we're listening. Anyway, so I want to play this as I would normally play any kind of RPG and tactical game, which is on standard. I know, everybody wants to go alpha editor, no damage run. And I'm telling you, no. Just no. I know what everyone's saying. I would love to do that. My only issue... sorry, it's not an issue. My only concern is I'm not going to have a lot of fun. Therefore, you're not going to have a lot of fun. You're going to see me die a lot, and I'm going to get very frustrated. So we're not going to do that. However, if I mean, obviously, we're here for a while. We're going to be streaming, obviously, all month and probably for the rest of the year. So if the community demand it, we might consider an alpha editor playthrough. I want to see you come together and convince me to do an alpha editor playthrough, because I'm not fully convinced yet. I don't know whether or not you guys want to see it. That's just how that goes. So if you are brand new to Miasma Chronicles, never played a tactical game before, then it is always kind of advised by ourselves that you either look at standard difficulty for those who play games regularly but are new to the tactical genre, or you take a look at narrative. Narrative is for players who want to experience the world and story without taking too much of a challenge. You will recover 100% of hit points post-combat. Most enemies deal less damage, and most enemies have less hit points. So it still have tactical combat. There are still some tactical elements in there, but it's a lot more forgiving, shall we say. We're going to be playing on standard. Now, a lot of people do like the challenge, so hard mode, okay. Basically, it's the opposite of narrative for experienced players of tactical games. And then, if you want to, you can go for Alpha Editor. Now, fun fact, Alpha Editor was something that we wanted to kind of bring in once you've already played the game before, but we decided to actually put it in because a lot of people like the challenge. However, we've also seen a lot of people not realize how challenging it is. Basically, it is like an Iron Man difficulty. It is difficult, some base rules are challenging difficulty with additional modifiers. Basically, manual save games are disabled. You cannot manual save. Unconscious heroes won't recover in combat, and difficulty cannot be changed. No, you cannot change the difficulty. Of course, if you do want the challenge, by all means, go for it. But this thing is designed to be brutal. And I am a bit of a casual guy. Sorry, that's just how I go. Brandon says we got through James and we will help. I'm sure. I'm so sure. So we're going to be playing on standard. Now, we've also given you two other options here as well. We have full tactical, a less predictable experience with more tension. Chances to hit in combat are much less reliable, both for you and your enemies. Or we could give you light tactical. Hit chances for weapons are more predictable. Flanking enemies will always guarantee a hit, and covers always grant the same bonuses regardless of distance. So again, if you want to like just experience the absolutely amazing story, and I'm telling you now, it really is. We tackle a lot of themes when it comes to ecological disasters, obviously the world as we're in it now, and just lots of corporate greed in there as well. So if you do want to just experience the story, which I really actually tend to prefer to play, then do that. And go for light tactical. However, if we want a bit of a challenge and we want to play this, and let's be bluntly honest, we kind of do, that's exactly what we're going to be doing. So, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to be beginning our definitive playthrough of Miasma Chronicles right now. We shall be continuing with these stipulations moving on until we complete the game. Chat, is everybody happy? Is everyone happy? I want to know if you're happy, Jawhead Nears. Alpha Editor is not as hard as some people say. Once you understand how the game works, it's easy. Look at this guy. Look at Progate. You know what? One thing I will actually mention is we celebrate everyone who 100%s the game on Alpha Editor. I'm telling you now, if you have 100%ed the game on Alpha Editor and you can prove that you have pinged that achievement, please let them us know over at 505 Games. We celebrate you, we stand with you. It's certainly something that oh my word, it's gonna be amazing. So are we all good? Are we all happy? I think C Squad's definitely happy crying about red pandas. The weirdo. Folks, let's play Miasma Chronicles. Chronicle 1, somewhere in Kentucky, 140 years after.
Keep my mind blank.
Oh, right, right. Breaking through a giant miasma wall. Don't need me yet.
She's on the other side of this wall.
Yeah. We ain't quitting. We'll find a little brother. We'll find her.
We will. Jawhead Nida in the chat says, I finished Alpha Editor Full Tactical yesterday on Xbox Series X. Give that man a round of applause. Let's get back to town.
Fix this
club. Can we get some love for Jawhead, please? Because that is a flipping feat, let me tell you. Well done, mate. Well done. That is awesome. So most of you who have dropped by my streams before have probably seen at least the beginning section.
This is the quickest way home.
At least before. We've definitely done this before. When we began our early look, we literally started from here.
So I'm not going to. How about we take a look around?
I'm not going to go through every nook and cranny and explain what's happening because everyone kind of knows, but I'll go through the main plot line. So obviously within the first couple of hours in the game is a little bit handy-holdy. The reason why is obviously to help.
Like it wants me to reach out.
Elvis, you sneeze in that thing and it'll turn you inside out. Now let's go home.
Yep, definitely sneeze in that. Excellent. It will literally rip you. Jawhead, near the end, the chat says the game is too loud. Is everyone else having the same issue? Chat, let me know what the audio issue is like and I can see if I can rectify it. It is pretty loud, says Franland. Right, give me I am changing the audio settings. Just dropping it down just a little bit. Hopefully that isn't as bad as we think. Yeah. Okay, cool. Chat, let me know how that goes. That'd be great. Thank you. That seems better. Wonderful. This is a thing with like playing games and just game audio just in general. It's there's a lot of noise happening. It's not like a consistent noise. So you're going to have peaks and troughs all the time. So it's a very fine balance, Ozzy. A very fine balance. Okay, let's go into that, shall we? Can hear you much better now. Fantastic. Thank you, SK. A great stability. I humbly accept this esteemed Peace Prize, not for myself, but for the pioneering spirit of all Americans. Yes, I am taking on the Jake Peralta of Brooklyn Nine-Nine pose. We have righted the wrongs of our forefathers, healed the scars that divide us, and put an end to hunger and war, a renaissance for humankind, a great stability. Now let us work together to share this American paradise with the whole world. Yes, there has been a great stability, folks.
Sick of being alone. We just want some family.
Not too far into the future.
You got your family right here. Me.
Somehow, yeah, but Diggs, the world has righted itself. Everything's been, everything's just
kick-ass brother.
Good. There's no hunger in the world. There's no debt in the world. There's no poverty in the world. The world is stable. How did that happen?
Locked. Need a key card to get in.
Okay, we need a key card. So let's go find said key card. I'm just hunting around here for plastic because you never know. You never know. Oh, there we go. I told you. You never knew. You didn't ever know. Let's have a look at a reconstructed voicemail. Jenny! Jenny there, it's Tommy. Hope to hell you get this message in time. I got the kids, we're shaking up, but doing okay. And he's asking where Mommy is. Telling her you're coming soon, but Max is completely obsessed with his toys, so good call on those. Listen, don't come to the bridge. Police are blocking the roads. Because, well, there are no roads. Meet me back at your uncle's place. Kids are safe. Everything's going to be fine. Oh, just one more thing I need. If anyone's looking for voice actors, just give me a call. You know what I mean? Just give me a call. I could do this. Right. I am after plastic, which is the currency in the game. So obviously Miasma Chronicles is out now, so I don't want to forgive me, I don't want to go too far ahead with regards to spoilers, of course. There are a lot of people who've not played this game yet. However, so we want to try and keep everything a little bit spoiler free to begin with, at least. However, I'm very curious. We know that Jarhead
must have been some meeting. Yikes.
We know that Jarhead has beaten the game and on Alpha Editor. First and foremost, Jarhead, like, you mentioned that it's a great game. What did you like about it? What did you enjoy about it? That's sweet loot.
Now we're talking. Sweet loot. Here I come.
Here I come. Holding up a hero to the... Oh, no, wrong one. There you go. Found a decent spot to hold up, working security at the door. Nice view of the city. Should be safe from the collectors until I make a run for the scar. Then it's just a game of waiting for the rest of the editors. If they make it, only time will tell. Gameplay, tactical, flight, stealth, everything. Dude, yeah!
Let me
I'm
sideways.
So glad you enjoyed it. I really am very happy you enjoyed it. We wanted to make a game that had an impact, as a societal impact, on the way that we are, the way that the world could become. And it sounds like a lot of people are kind of agreeing with these sentiments. So yeah. I'm so happy you enjoyed it. Really, really happy. Anyway, so I'm curious why... we don't want to go too far into spoilers, or spoiler territory, of course. But plastic is the currency here. And there's a reason for that.
I see it, but I don't believe it. What are those things?
Frogs.
Frogs walking on two legs, murdering people. Those are not animals.
Not people, neither. They're monsters. Goddamn monsters.
What are they doing with... Wait. Hold on. That's the Vodder family.
We gotta deal with these assholes. animals.
We don't fight anything we don't understand. We're going home.
Hey, you are aware the only way home is through them?
Shit.
Hey, get Tiger tough, little brother.
We're about to throw down.
Jock in the chat says, easy to say one by light left, but can't say too much without spoiling.
Dude,
that is very
these things
fair.
Are freaking huge.
Everyone should have their favorites.
Hey, you wanna get back
here
to town?
At 505 Games
trigger.
HQ, we stand Come digs. On. We stand digs very much. We do. Okay. Sorry about that. Combat is turn based. At the start of each turn, you get 2 action points per hero. I'm going to shoot that enemy. Yeah. Press right trigger to go, left trigger to the previous target. We'll take you out. Okay, so we're still in a little bit tutorial mode here, folks. We haven't got a lot of wiggle room to play around.
Luck never liked me that much.
Okay, enemies in partial cover will give you 35% chance penalty to shoot them. So if they're in partial cover, you have a 35% chance to left hit. So 65% chance to hit. Enemies in full cover give you a minus 75% chance penalty to shoot. Covers are only effective from the front. So the idea is to flank them. So for example, you can see here that we have a 33% chance to hit these creatures here. We're currently playing digs, so I'm just gonna quickly try and shoot this guy. Oh, I missed.
So you can see. Watch out.
Let's see if we can take out this one first. Yes, lucky shot. There is always a 50% chance that you get a lucky shot. And the same goes to your enemies as well.
But now he's behind full cover.
Can't get a clean shot.
Let's flank the bastard. Hit him from the side.
That's right. You gotta flank. So move to the side or behind them to flank him. Flank an enemy gives you a 0% chance hit. How was it? 0% chance hit penalty. So flanking them is more than likely you're going to hit. Sniper rifles have a higher chance at long range, whilst assault rifles have a higher chance at short range. Worth noting. Chances of bouncers and shotguns, we'll get them at some point, are unaffected by range. So I'm just going to quickly move Albus over there. And we are going to take out the temple. There we go.
You alive?
Yeah, I think so.
You?
Rocking and rolling, we made these boys extinct.
I don't think so. Look.
We got more boys, come on. So, chat, how is everyone doing? Is everyone all good? What is everyone's plans looking like this weekend? Okay, let's see how we do. Use cover to avoid getting hit by an enemy fire. Okay, let's do that. So I'm gonna, let's see. So I've got a bit of full movement here. We're still in the little tutorial section, but you can see what I mean here. So if I move Albus and you take a look at the tadpole scouts to my top left, right above, just there, then you will see that their percentage hit chance goes up or down depending on where I am. So if I move Albus there, I get 38% chance, 34, 50. Okay, I'm going to do that. I'm going to move Elvis over there. I'm going to try him. Ooh, 63. I'm going to see if I can go this way. Managed to it. It's a lucky shot. Let's move old Diggsy Doo. And I'm going to put him there. So 93% chance. Yes, okay, so that one's down, and now we've got one tadpole scout to go. Oh, you shouldn't have done that, big man. Come on. Okay, can I? Either way, I can't really get much of a cover, but I'm going to quickly go there. Just pelvis as well. Can I fly? I'm gonna fly. Remove Elvis there. And 100% chance hit.
Go!
Oh no!
Luckily, I have all digs. I'll definitely take that. Whoop.
You hear that?
More frogs looking for their buddies.
We just killed their buddies. We gotta get back to town now.
Also, speaking of the near future, look at this Tesla Cybertruck. Ain't that cool? To kill Rhino in the chat says, much better than I was. I'm so unhappy. That is amazing. I'm glad to see you're doing all right, dude. Thank you so much for dropping by. It's always good to see you in chat, mate. I hope you are doing well. I am doing really well, thank you, mate. I'm very, very happy to read all the comments and listen to all the reactions to Miasma Chronicles and actually get to finally play it and talk about it. And obviously, we don't want to go too far deep into spoiler territory here, but for those of you who have played, I would love to know your favorite characters. Why is this monitor kind of turn off? Travel text location. There we go.
You don't know what's making the Miasma angry, do you? To know what's making the Miasma angry, you have to know what Miasma is, what it really is. And you have no idea. At least you know how to fear it. That's good. You see it turn air into poison, nature into nightmares, frogs into monsters. You know you can't escape it. The Miasma surrounds your town like an ocean surrounds a lonely island. And it's spreading across America, twisting this once great nation into a lethal wasteland. So don't leave. Stay safe and sedentary. The dull, colorless mining settlement you've lived in your whole life. Put your head down. Work hard. Provide the gold that feeds America's rulers, the First Family. And pray the Miasma's anger doesn't wipe your town off the map. No one here is brave enough to conquer their fear or create their destiny, except you, Elvis. With your big brother, Diggs, and years of hard work, you've harnessed your glove's power, and now you want to find me. But you still don't know what it really is, do you? I could tell you, but revelations must be earned.
So
a secret. It shall remain. Maybe in the future,
it's as if I know this
you will be strong enough
thoughts.
To break through the wall and find me. And if you do, maybe I will tell you my secret. But we both know you'll die along the way. Because between me and you lies the Miasma.
Odin in the chat. What difficulty are you playing on then? Folks, welcome into the chat. The bearded ladies, marketing dude, an all-round awesome man who's joined me on a couple of streams. You may have known him before. Odin, can we get a round of applause, please, for Odin in the chat? He has asked, what difficulty are we playing on? And so, if you were here at the beginning, mate, you would have heard the discussions and heard my thoughts about what difficulty. We are playing on standard, full tactical. Now, what I'm planning on doing, so as I mentioned earlier as well, I couldn't transfer my save over from my previous game. The bearded ladies of 5-5 games wouldn't allow me to do it, so I'm having to start again. And to be honest, I would much rather start again anyway, just so I have a proper playthrough. I'm not skipping anything that I need to skip. But also, what we're going to be doing, we're going to be playing this until the end. Not today, I've definitely not got time for that. But we're going to be playing this until We beat it. And then we are going to put the community to task. I would love them to vote whether or not we do an alpha editor playthrough. Or we do it as part of some form of special event. Whatever it happens to be. It's the community that's going to drive this. So I need to get your feedback soon. Like I said, chat, make sure you get some love to Odin, please. He loves the attention. Katomi in the chat, a quick question. James, will there be some kind of roadmap? Katomi, I haven't got anything to say at the moment with regards to any further things for Miasma Chronicles, but when you do, you will be the first to know.
It's your house, too.
You should clean this yard up. Attract some customers.
Elvis's repair shop. So I'm just going to quickly mooch around Elvis's house at the moment.
I know a good cleaning robot. She'll get us a discount.
Keep talking to me about cleaning and I'll hang you up there.
We got a nice little medipod in there. That's a very dirty house there, Elvis. A very dirty house. I believe that is Elvis's letter. Tonight is the night, Elvis. I must go. I must leave sedentary. Diggs will take care of you until you're able to take care of yourself. With his help and years of hard work, you will learn to harness the glove's power. And when you do, come find me beyond the Miasma Wall. There, I will tell you who you really are and who you must become. Promise me that I've promised you, your mother, Barmardi. So, Barmardi has asked us to find her.
Mom's picture. What do you remember about her?
Not a lot. Didn't get much quality time.
Kill a rhino in the chat.
I keep dreaming
hopefully
about
the hardest.
She's
a pro. I am a pro.
Her giving me this
glove. I am a professional gamer,
she put
ladies and gentlemen. I am
me.
About as pro as you get. I click heads and I rip them to shreds, as the Mr. Andy Cortez of Kind of Funny fame will mention.
Mama would be proud.
But just to make sure that I get through this in an enjoyable manner, and I'm thinking of the chat here. I'm not thinking of myself, I'm thinking of the chat. I want to make sure that we get through this pretty nicely, and that's why we're going through standard.
Hey, ooh. I just got that.
I'm trying to quickly pick that up. There we go. Some plastic there. There's some black water beer. For those of you who haven't seen, we did a little vlog of the launch day. We joined the bearded ladies out in Malmo in Sweden, and we decided to film a little video. You can catch that over on Instagram, over on the 505 Games TikTok, and on YouTube. So make sure that you check that out. And you might see
what's
some black water
to?
Beer.
Hey, try this moonshine. Daddy's recipe.
You're
like
welcome, Katomi. Thank
Bingo.
You for your
and
support,
some
mate.
Tree bark and tire rubber. I mean, you can make moonshine from just about anything, guys. Well, in a town of dwindling resources, improvisation is key. Just don't tell the sheriff.
Don't tell the sheriff. Okay,
you're
let's
telling
have a look
me
at
that
monsters.
Outside of
what's
town
Caleb
right now
us?
There's just a bunch of monsters? Like real monsters?
Yeah. They killed the Vodder family. I think they're coming for the town.
Whew. I need a drink. It's moonshine o'clock somewhere, right?
They're huge. Bulletproof, too.
Maybe they got some kind of big boss alpha type monster. If we kill that boss, we might see the weaker ones back down, and, well, by we, I mean you. Damn law's been on my ass all week. Look, I didn't kill Clint Boone. Moonshine killed Clint Boone, all right?
Who did kill Clint Boone?
What do I got to do with it? I ain't worried. Sheriff Zebedee can barely walk now.
What happened to him?
My asthma infection in his knee got us tracking some thiever in the Badlands.
Sounds painful.
Sounds pathetic. Now he's trying to recruit people to be his deputies.
Rhino, you need to jump onto this and show it off to the community. You must, mate. You're going to... I know you, sir. You are going to have the best time, trust me. Have you played much? I've played a fair bit. Fun fact, though, I'm laying this out now. I have not beaten the game yet. I've not beaten the game. I know, obviously, I know the beats. I know what is going to happen, etc. But I have not actually sat down and beat the game. I know, working in video games gets all the time to play games. I'm telling you now, that's not what happens in community management at all. but I've yet to beat the game. I'm hoping that we can do it together.
Hell, I remember our last bottle of whiskey.
I had a beer.
Fran has made it
back
to the end.
Oh, don't even get me started on beer. God, I miss beer.
There's a lot of the community out there that actually know a little bit more about this game than I do.
Know she died.
That's weird.
She's alive. We just
That's
got
very
divorced.
Weird. I don't know why. So, I just admitted that.
I'd never want to betray her confidence, but do you keep a secret? She stashed her valuables somewhere in the town.
Kilmer Chess says, plastic, I can mad reveal busy, to you I see where the stash is. Of course,
you
of course. Thank you again.
Steal your wife's stuff?
No, not me. You. You should steal it. If you leave her with nothing, she's going to come back to me. Look, man, you'd be doing me a real solid. Just give me 50 plastic, I'll tell you the location of her treasure.
Have I got 50 plastic?
Ah, yes, good man. There's a gate behind the bar. Unlock it with this key and thank me later.
Okay.
Keep on living, amigos.
Keep on living, amigos. Thank you, Caleb. Caleb has just introduced us to the fact that there are treasures to be found within Sedentary. Interesting. And he mentioned that there is something at the back of the bar. So I'm just going to quickly go back to here. Oh, there it is. Ooh, got some plastic. Go get the plastic.
That's nice.
There's the Stick of Joy. A curiously contoured device was said to bring great happiness to lonely people who lived out their fantasies away from the outside world. As to where this was used exactly, records are uncertain. Perhaps you should use your imagination like the previous owner. Okie dokie. So, I don't want to necessarily rush through this, but as you know, we've kind of played through this area before, so I'm conscious of that, and I want to make sure that we actually get through this. So, we'll get through as much of this as we possibly can. So, let me just quickly head to the mayor.
Elvis, the boy with the magic glove.
Mayor, listen, this is gonna sound crazy, but we saw monsters. Real monsters.
What's with the hunched shoulders and sour puss, boy? I keep telling you, if you don't project power, someone's gonna take it from you.
You heard what he said, old man. Monsters, right outside town.
I'm talking to the smart one. You tin-brained nitwit.
Okay, say that again.
Diggs, calm down.
Trash can.
What's he yakking about, monsters?
That's what they were. Big, nasty frog things. They killed the Vodder family. Damn near killed us, too. Loads of them are coming for the town. You gotta do something.
I knew this day was coming.
What you mean you knew?
It was the last full moon. The mayor of Pikeville was screaming at me on the radio about some invasion. I sent the sheriff out there for a look-see. He said the townspeople were gone, and the streets were covered with giant sacks of eggs. Frog eggs.
I
we can't let that happen here. You can get the town to fight.
This is a mining town. We mine.
I think the actor who plays Mason.
We need to act differently. It's more important than ever. You get through that wall and find your mama, Bahmati. She's the only one who might know what's going on. Like it or not, Elvis, the fate of our town is in your fingers.
Yeah, about my fingers. The glove's dead. I blew out the power core.
Well, go find a new power core and come back here pronto. I'll take another look at your mama's data drive. See if she left any clues on how to keep that glove from breaking. And one more thing. Do not leave town. It's too dangerous out there.
Cool, don't leave town. Woo! Level up. Right, I'm just gonna quickly just scout around here. The party has just gained a level. As the party levels up, all party members gain 5 health as well as 1 skill point to be used in their specific skill decks. Each hero's skill deck is found in the party screen. We'll check that out in just a second. I'll check that out in just a second as well. I don't necessarily want to go through a lot of this stuff because I kind of want to, if I'm being honest with you, I want to rush through as much of this as I can so I can catch up to where we were. I believe
one place to get a power core.
The last stream we did, we left it. It's still pretty early on, but we left it with Baxter.
Hell no, get out.
Bertha, please. All we need is one fresh power core.
You blew up my car. Last damn car in town. You know how expensive that thing was?
I do, and I'm sorry. My glove misfired, and... listen, we're on official mayor business.
Official mayor business.
I don't care if the mayor comes here and karate chops me with his tiny arms. Supplies are limited. I got merchants disappearing in the miasma. First family's giving me shittier gear, but if you happen to find me a torque jammer, maybe I'll forgive you for killing my car and give you a power core.
Listen, we don't have...
I got your torque jammer, Bertha.
Oh, yeah?
It's right out back, and, Bertha, while I'm out there, I'll be holding on to the memory of your beautiful face.
Okay. Get me that jammer, and the core is yours. Better hurry. It's my last one.
Oh, Diggs, you flirt.
What the hell are you telling her?
Grabbing a torque jam is easy, little brother. Just gotta know where to grab.
Border's been picked clean.
Screw the border. We can go to Gator Zone. Your call.
I'm going to Gator Zone.
Right, let's just quickly have a look at this party screen. So again, some people might not realize what this party screen is and how this works. The party screen shows the current status of the heroes in your party. Within the screen, you can equip and modify weapons, items, and miasma powers. You can also open each hero's skill deck later in the game. You'll be able to swap out party members. You mean you can swap out party members? Yes. Skill deck. In the skill deck, you can exchange points for new active and passive tactical skills. Later, skills will become available when your previous skill in its repetitive branch has been unlocked. Skill points can be refunded, so you can easily reconfigure your hero's skill deck at any time outside of combat. So that basically means you can refund any skill. So if you feel as though you have gotten into a bit of a pickle when you were trying to get through a fight and you can't quite make it, then it might be worth reconfiguring your party. Go into the skill deck, refund some of the skills, and respec just to see what works. It's always good to see. All skills are available in combat, and active skills have cooldowns that last for a number of turns before they can be used again. Pandorian Grey in the chat over on Twitch has said, is this out already? Yes! Yes, it is! Miasma Chronicles is out now on PS5, Xbox Series X and S. Epic Games, Steam, and GOG for the personal computer players. Next week, Miasma Chronicles will be available in your favorite retail stores in Europe, as well as in North America on the 20th of June. So it is out, folks. It is out. Bear with me just a second. I'm just going to quickly just check something. Give me a second. Just want to make sure everything is displaying on Twitch correctly. It should be. I'm pretty sure it is. It is. Okie dokie, that's cool. Welcome to live video production, folks. Right, okay. Elvis. I'm going to give Elvis the Overwatch skill, which is a tactical implant which allows users to guard a specific area. Any enemies moving through the Overwatch cone will be targeted instantly. For something truly special, try this with a crowd of enemies whilst using a weapon holding multiple rounds of ammo. Useful. Let's switch to Diggs. We can give him some health, we can give him a big bro status, or I'm going to give him a sprint and shoot. Tactical implant, which can give users increased mobility in short burst. Basically, allows a bonus action after sprinting. We'll get to that in a moment. Actually, before I do forget, I'm pretty sure someone has a scope. Yes, I'm going to give that to Elvis. Yes, it's out. Draw ahead in the chat. What would have been awesome was to have two loadouts per character, including dex. I think it said dex. To avoid changing every accessory, weapon, skills depending on the situation. That is not a bad idea. That is actually quite a good idea. I'm sure we'll take that back to the team and we'll look into that. Obviously, balancing is very important. Here. We don't necessarily want to go too far into lots of different situations, but it is really interesting to note anyway.
Oh my. I'm kidding. I couldn't keep you out of it if I tried. You want some herbs?
Trying to quit, Hattie, so I can focus. But thanks.
So much of your mama in you. Wisdom is obtained by listening to the miasma. Do you know how it got here?
The miasma? No one knows.
I do. No heroes.
No heroes?
Without heroes, America drowned in poison. The poison impregnated Mother Earth. She gave birth to a demon child, the miasma. She hates us.
Jarhead, you're doing the best you can, mate.
Mother Earth hates us.
You probably speak better English than me.
Don't take it personal. Turn your frown upside down, like I do. Namaste.
Namaste. What's this herb that hides on
the miasma produces some breathtaking plant life. If you see any unusual plants on your wanders, bring them to me, yes?
Don't have time to smell the flowers out there, Hattie. Fear keeps us moving.
I love
fear. Fear is hope upside down. Fear is hope doing a handstand.
You say some weird shit sometimes.
I'm the town crazy lady. What do you want me to say?
Big fan of the town crazy lady.
See ya.
We love Hattie here. So fun fact, Hattie will give you a side quest later on. Or at least you will begin to find some quests. So it's certainly worth keeping an eye out for some flowers. Oh, excuse me. I've got some, I really need to get that looked at. I really do. Okie dokie. Let me just quickly go.
I'm not crazy.
Think there's it anything the show can get me done. I'm getting stuff anyway. We'll have a look at this.
Hell, this. Who are you, man?
Who am I?
Yeah, skinny little you, kicking froggy ass. News travels fast. You in the hero business now?
No, I'm a mechanic.
Bitch, please. I throw a talk jammer in the air, I hit a mechanic. What I need is a warrior. The mayor asked me to hire some deputies. You in?
Listen, Frank, we're...
This is my house. You call me Sheriff in my house.
Sheriff? The mayor didn't say anything about deputies.
Sure. You're too busy trying to get through a wall you're never gonna get through. Peachy. Until then, Peachy. Your town needs you. Do you need your town?
I guess.
I'll take that as a yes. You are hereby
so flipping cryptic. So cryptic.
Look out for each other.
So, again, folks, we want to try and get—I want to try and get through as much of this as quickly as I possibly can, or at least certainly catch up to our previous playthrough. For those of you who do who tuned in previously, you would have known that we kind of got a good like 4 to 5 hours in. So it's going to take a little while to catch up, but I want to make sure that I've explored every nook and cranny before I go into the game. So just for the, as people are just tuning in, and as a bit of a reminder, folks, welcome to 505 Games Plays. My name is James, I am a brand community manager here at 505 Games, and I have been working alongside the bearded ladies, with Miasma Chronicles. That is correct. Miasma Chronicles is out now. It is available on digital platforms from PS5, Xbox Series S and X and S, Steam, Epic Games, and GOG. Make sure that you give it a... if you've not wishlisted the game or not bought... If you've not bought the game, make sure you wishlist it. And if you're not wishlisted the game...
What's your name?
Well, wishlist it. Buy it. Come on.
Get the hell away from me before I pop the cap.
Hi, the Gaming Dad over on YouTube. Nice, so totally need to play this too. After I finish Bone Totem. Yes, you do. Yes, you do. We have bought up such an amazing community since Miasma Chronicles launched. It is absolutely wonderful, and we want you to be a part of that. We really do. We want to give a massive thank you and shout out to every single member of the community who has picked it up, who has given us some feedback, done some amazing comments, and has created some amazing photos as well. The virtual photography community are... We've always loved the virtual photography community here at 505. The stuff that you guys do for Death Stranding and Control have been mind-blowing. We were not expecting this for Miasma Chronicles, but I... Honestly, tears came down my face when I saw some of Shinobi Space's shots, and everyone else's shots as well. They are beautiful. We want to celebrate the launch of Miasma Chronicles with you, and that's exactly what we're going to be doing throughout the month of June. We have lots of streams happening, whether or not that is live gameplays. We'll see if we can get some people in from 505 Games and the Bearded Ladies to join us as well. We're also going to be doing a board game stream, everybody, where we are going to be giving away a copy of the board game to a lucky viewer. So keep an eye over on the socials, follow Miasma Chronicles over on Steam, and join into the community forums if you haven't done so already. We have a lot of really cool things happening within the community to celebrate this launch. So keep your eyes out for all updates. Speaking of updates, I want to give again a massive shout out and thank you to everyone who has sent us reports with regards to bugs or a little bit of issues and feedback with regards to the game. Updates did begin to roll out this week. You may have seen them for PS5 and PC players. Yes, Xbox players, we have
Bastard,
not forgotten you.
Shouldn't be out here.
We also have some updates cooking as
out
we speak,
find
and we're looking to get them out very, very
it's
soon.
Bad news out here.
You're not my
keep
dad,
an eye
Elvis.
On the socials for all updates as
we're
well.
Still friends, right?
We have them pretty much all raring to go. We have
this
listened to every
evil,
single
Baxter.
Piece of feedback you
and
guys have
too
got. And I believe we've actually addressed
I'm
quite a lot
of it
as well.
Seriously,
so keep an eye on some news we'll have with
you
very,
you
very soon.
Hole,
thank
like,
you so
turn
much.
Turn you into soup or some shit.
Aw, sounds like you're sweet on me. Is he sweet on me, Diggs?
Yeah.
No.
Oh, dude. I love Baxter.
What?
It's cool, I get it. Who has time for friends when you're looking for family?
Ty and the Gaming Dad and the chat on YouTube
you're
says, I'm very glad
friend,
it's been sold on GOG. Thank you for offering
busy.
It on so many storefronts.
Soon,
thank you for letting us know where you would like to play it. We then get in touch with said storefronts and we try and make that happen. It's a very fine balance to kind of get stuff like this done. Fun fact, game dev. But we could try and make it happen for people to play as much as we can.
You don't get it.
Honestly, Miasma Chronicles is a game that everyone really needs to play.
What?
And we want you to play it.
I should have saw this coming. The last few weeks, there's been this hyper spike in Miasma's flux signals. Like it's getting...
angry?
Exactly. Someone, something, is pissing it off. Screw bad news. I need some good news. You got any?
Well, nobody killed me today.
Wow. Real blast of sunshine, Elvis. You know the difference between me and you.
I got a metal glove and you got a metal arm.
Cute. Difference is, I know who I am.
Elvis is such a flipping,
but you're looking for someone to tell you who you are.
Okay.
Nerdy teenager.
Tell me who I am.
I can't. You are who you want to be.
I mean, again, you've got to think of it, though.
Choose.
Like, his mother left him at a very young age.
Wow, that's some deep shit, Baxter.
She's
going to
have a lot of attachment issues, and he's going to be a little bit distant.
You, Elvis.
He wants
Don't get
family.
Lost out
he
there.
Wants a hug from his mom. Like, that is Elvis, folks. I'm also pretty sure there's something over here. Ah, there is, yes. Gotta get that plastic. You gotta get that plastic. I also know where things are, so don't worry about it. Again, I'm just rushing through this.
Ah, shit. More frog monsters.
Keep cool, little brother. Remember hunting coyotes with Mama? If we sneak up on the bastards, we can ambush them. That gives us the first move.
What if they see us?
Where's Gru?
You can split with your group. Split up members can be hidden in any cover position. While hidden, a shadow passive skill is applied, hiding your hero from the enemy. Spread out and find great positions before you engage in combat. That is the plan. So before we go, we always hunker down. And we are going to split the group up. So I'm going to get Diggs to just sit there for a little bit. We've got a bit of a hint that we can go there. I'm just going to quickly... do I want to get Diggs here, or do I want Elvis there? I'm going to put... You know what? I'm going to put Elvis somewhere else. So we'll put him there. There we go. I'm going to hide Elvis. I'm going to swap to Diggs. And I'm going to put Doozy Doo. Oh, do we take him out of that tadpole? Diggs is going to get a good flank in there. Which is good.
What do you think will happen if I shoot those fuel cans?
Whammo, blammo, bye-bye, froggy.
Okie dokie. Well, first things first, let's switch to Elvis then. And I'll see if I can get... Yes! So, folks, of course it's video games. We've got exploding barrels. We need to utilize said exploding barrel. And when you utilize said exploding barrel, that tadpole scout is gonna go boom. Oh, it went boom. That tadpole's skull crusher. We have a 76% chance of hitting with a 15% chance to crit. We're gonna move him there. 15% chance to crit.
Toasted.
Okay. This tadpole scout is moving over there. He's gonna give Elvis a bit of a kick in. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna sprint and shoot with old Diggsy Doo. And we're gonna put him there. We've got an 88% chance to hit, 15% chance to crit. Then we're good. Good. Yes! We are going to move Elvis for 100% chance to hit. Bear. And that froggy is now sleeping with the fishes.
Nothing good happens in Gator Zone.
I can smell that torque jammer from here. Some other loot too. Look around.
Okay, so before we save the world, we do need to loot the place. We need to steal everything. No, that's just video game 101. Let's see, what else have we got here? So again, we are quite early in the game, so things are still feel a little bit hand-holdy, as you can tell within the combat, just to kind of give you some heads up as to what is around and what we can do will be some choice options. Digs can break down wooden barriers. Elvis can also break down, can also do things. I believe he is a mechanic. He is a mechanic. So he can, I believe that you will find some robots throughout the world and he can restart them. And other party members will have secret things that they can do as well. Okay, we've got another barrier there. We always say hello to Mark the Gator King as we break through here. Hello, Mark. We drop by there. Okay, where do we go next? We've got to move forward. I think we're over there. Yeah. Not say anything else. Nope, that's good. Oh, see the gators!
That old timer needs help.
Oh, Rusty.
We'll sneak in and ambush these bastards.
What the hell are you what do you want from me?
Okay, so we have a tadpole skull crusher who is walking. We have a moving target, folks. We've got another tadpole scout there, another tadpole skull crusher. We've also got another walking. That's a scout. It is a scout. So be mindful of walking enemies. So what I'm going to do is I am going to put
somebody help me.
Elvis there. Elvis, you hide. And you switch to Diggs. And I'm going to flank him with Diggs. Have we got like? I thought there was a burning barrel somewhere. Okay, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to now ambush. Red indicate positions that are flanked by enemies. Stars indicate that cover can be destroyed by things like shotguns and explosives. Interesting. So what I'm going to do, let's just see what we've got. We have a tadpole skull crusher right in front of Elvis, scout there, a tadpole skull crusher there, and a scout there. I'm pretty sure that's a skull crusher at the top. Yes, it is. So I'm going to switch to Elvis, and I'm going to put an Overwatch on. So we're going to get Overwatch to cover those three. So we've got the skull crusher, we've got the scout, and another skull crusher. So basically what will happen on the enemy's turn when an enemy walks into that cone, we call it the cone of shame, they get shamed. They get shot in the face. So I'm going to just quickly just drop Diggs in here. I'm going to quickly see what we can do. We kind of want to get rid of that scout. The skull crusher only got 50 damage. Although, I'm thinking I might take out this skull crusher near Elvis. The reason why is because he's very close to, I think, attacking Elvis. Oh, actually, is he? No. I think we're good. Let's go. Let's see if we can get this tadpole scout. 76% chance to hit. 70%. 25% crit. Let me just see if I can move them. Oh, he's going to see me if I move. I'm going to lose the ambush. Okay, come on. Oh,
miss!
Okay. That tadpole scout is... been shot. We've got a scout over here. The scout missed, yes. Skull crusher down.
That's right.
Oh, not bad.
I'm hoping you're gonna go on the cone of shame. Yes, you are. In the face.
Nice and easy.
I taught you how to do that. Don't forget.
Oh!
Got it.
Oh! Oh, yeah! I'm doing all right, folks. I am doing all right, if I don't say so myself. Okay, I can't sprint and shoot, so I'm gonna move. Dig's over there, and I'm going to 60% chance. 61% chance. Elvis needs to reload.
Time to reload.
But I can't. Oh, I don't think I can really. Nah, it's not good long range. So I'm going to quickly move him to there. This scout is going to take a pop shot at me, I reckon. Well, a gamer over on YouTube wants to ask a question, of course. Welcome in. Okay, I'm gonna quickly move Elvis. Blank, we got 100% chance there. Chance. It is a blank though. Can I get 100% there? No, 65. I'm gonna go from the side. Come on.
Check out. Let's check on the old man.
You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying, folks? Those that know, they know. Waleed, what is your question? Okay, I'm going to quickly loot the place first. Got a nice little burning truck there. We've got to talk to old Rusty. Let's talk to old Rusty.
He has saved my life. Hey, you're Bomati's boy, aren't you?
Yeah, that's me. You better get back to sedentary.
Like that safer? Your ma used to protect our town. You know that? Without her magic, don't know how we're gonna keep this evil from killing us.
As sure as night turns to day, old man, we're gonna find her.
Yeah? And you're gonna need my backpack. I got a frag grenade and
medipod
inside.
It's as if the backpack is like a flipping.
Guess you're saving our lives.
You're gonna need mine.
Much obliged, old timer.
Thank you, Rusty. The backpack, I believe, is accessed by every. Accessed by every party member. The backpack contains all consumable items you found. You can also access and use healing items in the backpack when not in combat. Remember that. You can heal out of combat, folks. All you have to do is get into the backpack. That's pretty it. Pretty much it. Okay, so I want to try and hurry this along. I want to see if we can at least try and find Jade before we stop the stream, which means I need to get a move on. Let me just quickly pick up a few bits and pieces before I do. Keypads. Okay, so you may find some keypads in the world, and you will also find hints to the actual code scattered throughout the world. Now, I'm pretty sure I found the code. Did I find the code? There's the thing. So there's a codex here, new keypad. Let's quickly read it. The new keypad works perfectly. Thanks for getting it installed so fast. We should really get rid of, or at least disable, the old pad. It won't be long until a curious visitor works out the sequence. So make sure that you check out the archives of things when you see the keypad, because they will give you clues. And you can see to the left of this keypad is an old keypad with flashing numbers. I wonder. One, two, three. Oh, it's two? Hang on, I missed the other one. Okay, something four. So some one, two, one, two, three, four, five, six, six, four. And keypads will definitely unlock really nice little bits and pieces that you might find throughout the world that you might need.
Today's my lucky day.
A vintage recolor, for example. We've got some more plastic. And we've got a chest.
Sweet.
Oh, we got a shotgun. Oh, hell yeah. Level 1 shotgun. 40% damage, 60% critical damage, 7 range. 2 ammos, no mod slots yet. But what I'm going to do... So I'm going to quickly go into my party screen. I'm going to be a nice old gentleman. And I'm going to unequip Diggs's rifle. I'm going to give him the shotgun because Diggs... I'd like to equip Diggs with a shotgun. I think he works quite well with a shotgun. I'm also going to... have I got that range scope? No, I gave it to Elvis, didn't I? I'm gonna get rid of that rain scope on Elvis, and I'm gonna give it to Diggs and put it on the shotgun. So it's gonna extend this range of this shotgun, which is gonna be very useful. Flingol in over on twitch.tv/505games in the chat says, was totally waiting for that to set off a trap. Be mindful. Be mindful, that's all I'm going to say. And loving the look of the game so far, getting Fallout vibes. Mate, thank you very much. It's a wonderful game. You really should check it out. Miasma Chronicles is out now. It is made by the Bearded Ladies, the team that bought you Mutant Year Zero. And it's out on all platforms, so PlayStation 5, Xbox Series X and S, and PC, Steam, Epic, and GOG. It is available now. We are getting retail versions coming very soon. Over in Europe, over in Europe, it will be available on the 9th of June, so next week. And over in North America, it will be from the 20th of June. It is a tactical turn-based RPG, so very... I get your point. It's very, Fallout vibes. I definitely feel your tone.
The originals fought these monsters,
I think it's
in a great war.
A lot deeper than Fallout.
History repeats, I guess.
Certainly from a narrative in a world. This is a world that has actually, it was fine. The world actually, the great stability happened. It was a moment in time in which the world was at peace. There was no wars. There was no hunger. There was no droughts, but something happened. It's like an ecological disaster happened.
These bastards.
And well, we're
we
here.
We gotta take them down. Hold on now.
Sorry, Flint. Nothing for the Commodore 64 or the Sega Mega Drive, guys. I'm really sorry.
Shine, little brother.
Pretend the sword is in the chat. What's up, my friend? Thank you so much for dropping in. I think this is the first time I've seen Sun in this game. What? It's like early on. Come on. Oh, we've got Cork the Great here. We need to be very, very careful. So let me just double check what we do have. We've got a Tapple Scout there. He's gonna come round the corner any minute. I'm gonna quickly split them up. I'm gonna put Diggs, you stay. Hide, thank you. It's not always raining. Not everyone's dying. You've clearly not been to the DRC yet. Where am I putting Elvis? Where can I put old Elvis? You know what, I might put him here. Oh, actually. You know what? There's some red barrels there. Give me a second. Hold your breath, everybody. James is going stealth. Gotta hold your breath, make sure we scout the place first. Oh, I got a minute! Can I get out there? I can. Come on. I want to time this just right. I'm quickly gonna hide. I want to time this just right because we can see there we have some red barrels. So I want to get him, that tadpole scout, into that barrel. Okay, we're gonna ambush. Diggs is, what's that shotgun looking like? Ooh. Not what I was expecting, to be honest, but never mind. Let's just quickly swap my hand now. With 91% crit hit on that, 66% chance on call. I haven't got an Overwatch for all this, have I? Oh, I've got turns to go. Let's do it. Let's do it. Woo! That froggy go fly. Okay, we have, I'm gonna quickly, can I get, I'm gonna, ooh, do I take that crusher? I'm gonna take that crusher.
Almost, Diggs.
I missed at 91%.
Got that left.
Jarhead in the chat says you can end this fight in 3 turns. No, I didn't. I definitely didn't. Wallet, you've got nothing to apologize for. Unfortunately, I'm not entirely sure what you mean by your question. But I'm wondering if someone else in chat can help. Anti-C in the chat says, hi, cool game. A good job has been done. Everything is as I like, the plot, the turn-based strategy. Thank you ever so much. Again, this community is freaking amazing. Thank you. I'm so happy you enjoy this game. Right, okay. Yeah, backpack. Is the 505 website down? Just curious. Just continuously loading for me, says Flynn Gold in the chat. Folks from 505, can I get someone to just quickly look at that, if that's okay? I just want to make sure we're not down, and we're doing all right.
What you gonna do, coward? Nothing!
A butternut, thank you, butternut. Open that backpack. We do have a nice little flag grenade there. Or do I put Overwatch on first? The thing is, if I do that, I mean, Cole's going to try and hit me anyway. Can I move out this again? I think I've already moved him once. No. Yeah, let's put this out there for a second. Let's do that. Then we'll get in the backpack for Diggs. We'll throw that grenade. Over on Korg.
Don't look up!
And then I'm also gonna shoot this skull crusher in the face. So what should happen is these Tadpole Scout is going to go after, get into cover. The Skullcrushers are going to move. Oh, Cork's moved. So I've got a shot on him. The Skullcrushers should move. Yes, one down. And the other one should move. Yes! Come on!
Took me long enough.
Diggs, we've got another shot on Diggs here, so I'm going to quickly move him. Can I get him to take on Korg? I think I can. Chance of hits, 15% chance to crit.
Yeah, it did.
Yes.
Did it again.
Yes.
You sure?
And we're going to get Elvis. Elvis needs to reload. Elvis can't make that shot though, but he can get there. Let me just. I only made that shot. Oh, what are you doing, mate? Can you go there? Can you make that?
Think of see this every day.
Oh, I know what I've done. Like an absolute muppet. Didn't realize I was still had a shot to go. Move Diggs over there.
Kill you now, human!
Bastard got me!
I've got a bit confused with what I was doing. I'm not gonna lie. Can I get a good old shot there? Can I get a good? I'll get a good shot there. Let's do that. As you can tell, folks, I am not the best tactical player, which is why we're playing on standard. I'm going to put Albus there. I'm going to get him to pop off.
Are you right?
Yeah, barely.
Oof. You?
Shit, I can do this all week.
All week, apparently. How about the greatest
thing go home?
All week, okay. You can do it. Oof. I'm just making sure I've got all the loot. We did see a gator just then, if anyone paid attention.
A torque jammer. Rusty, but it'll do. Let's get back to Bertha.
Let's just make sure I've got everything. Diggs has energy for days. Diggs is a robot. He didn't run out of energy. Making sure I've got everything. I'm pretty sure I have. Just squeaky. He doesn't. Diggs needs oiling every now and again. You gotta oil Diggs every now and again. You gotta oil your Diggs every now and again. Just squeaky, squeaky, squeaky. Okie dokie. Right, I think we're good. So I'm gonna quickly fast travel back to Sedentary. There we go. I'm quite interested to see. It's very interesting to see everyone's different approaches to things. So if you are a content creator you are a streamer, a YouTuber, and you do like video based combat, I would love to
Let's
see.
Let's get this torque jammer to Bertha.
How you tackle these particular fights. I've got my kind of.
Thanks, Diggs.
Skipping again. I've got my ways of how I kind of like tackle things. I also
Elvis and Diggs, get over here.
I'll talk to people.
The evil energy surrounds our town on all sides, but
see.
We
Where
shall
is,
not
oh,
be.
Oh, there is Bertha. What is her name, Bertha?
Here's that torque jammer, Bertha. Just like
Elvis
promised.
Doesn't clean him yet.
Hey,
I don't
hey.
Know him. He does.
Took you a while. Thought somebody killed you,
I'm
boys.
Sure.
And me and Elvis, we don't kill easily.
Deal's a deal. Here's a power core. Don't blow yourself up now.
Mm-hmm. It's all about maths and stats. Interesting, Jarhead. I must admit, this is probably one of my first like tactical games I've ever really played. Wanna sell it? I am learning quite a lot, and I'm certainly understanding a lot of the strategies that can go in it. Like I said, I might not have beaten the game fully, but I certainly know how best I certainly do well with it, if that makes sense. Right, okay, give me a second. So I'm just going to go to the points screen. I'll go to my skill deck. And I'm gonna give Elvis an Armorita shot, which will remove 2 armor points from target. And Diggs. I'm gonna increase his health. I'm also gonna give Diggs. I've got a power core for Diggs. Has 1 time when moving, 2 when sprinting. Let's give that to all Elvis, I think. Only tactical games I've played are Miasma and Mutant, so interesting! And just out of interest, and just for curiosity's sake, which one's better?
Got that glove working, boy?
It's working, Mayor, not a second too soon. Gator Zone's crawling with monsters.
Why the hell were you in Gator Zone? This brainless bot dragon?
Brains is all you got, Jarhead.
Elvis, I hit the jackpot. Found an encrypted file in your mama's data drive. It's all about increasing your glove's power.
Hell yeah. What's it say?
Well, that's the problem. I can't understand a goddamn lick of it. Read this.
To heal the miasma and pay our debts. Absorb the anger of a wild
yes, Jarhead. That was the right answer.
In turn, the miasma gives an editor a reward. Power for your glove, and balance restored.
Some kind of riddle. You know what she means?
Heal the miasma. Editor? I don't get it.
Me neither. What's a vortex?
Damn it. Trying to figure out miasma's like punching a tornado.
Tornado. Hold on. Near the wall, we saw some angry miasma.
Yeah, swirling around.
Like a vortex. The glove was pulling me to it like it wanted to grab it.
Maybe it did. You should go investigate. Could be the key to everything. But the frogs are out there too. Could be dangerous.
Want to see danger? You looking at him, old man? Elvis, clock's ticking. Let's go.
Jarhead cool. In the chat over on twitch.tv/55games says, only thing I miss from you digging through these is files tactical for being more a silent skill, and skills reset on kills instead of turns. Interesting. Great feedback, guys. Like I said, we began doing updates this week, so stay tuned for more information on those. We will be able to announce some things very, very soon. And make sure that you follow Miasma Chronicles all over on social media, whether or not that is Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, Reddit, Discord. Make sure that you come and join us and have a chat. The community is certainly something we celebrate here, not only just at 5-5 Games, but also with the Bearded Ladies, and also certainly for the people at Team Miasma. So we want to celebrate with you, and you're the best people to help us celebrate, you know what I mean?
Bodies are gone. Frogs must have come back to finish the meal. Nasty.
Ugh. It's a bit grim. Right, okay. Now, I have been burnt on this fight a couple of times. For those of you who actually saw my first stream, I got my ass handed to me on this one.
Frog monsters.
This is a tough one.
As nasty as the last
this ones. Is a tough no one to begin back. With.
Time to kick some
to
ass.
Kind of, once you've kind of got the vortex, got the torque jammer and onto the vortex, this can be quite a tough fight to be dropped into. So, you know what? It's totally fine if you die every now and again. You know what I mean? It's all good. Okay, I'm just gonna quickly do here as well. So we have a Skull Crusher, we have a Scout, and we have That's it, really. Skullcrushers, scouts, and scouts. So actually, hopefully, it shouldn't be too bad. Okay, I'm going to quickly grab this medipod just in case. We have someone by the barrels. So. This way for a change. Oh, that's exactly what we're
going to do. Going solo.
I'm going to get Alvis up here and climb up. I can't hide. Yes. I'm going to quickly switch to Diggs. I'm going to get Diggs behind this squad car. To ambush. First things first, we are going to shoot that barrel. I'm going to take out that scout.
Whee! Go to sleep.
Diggs is here, ladies and gentlemen. We are going to. Have I got anyone? Not really. I love a good shotgun, but if no one's really in my range. Chance to crit if I do a skull crush, 19% chance of hit. Maybe. Oh, nearly. Nearly. System works well, says Jared over on Twitch, but I could see a combination of the two, like skills reset on kills. If kills are silent when in turn combat, it goes back to turns. Interesting. Okay, Diggs is having a bit of trouble. Don't you worry, old Diggsy Doo. We're gonna grab you a lovely little shotgun there. We're gonna hit and go. Boom!
Another one bites the rust. You got it.
Another one bites the rust.
Get out of here. Go.
And another one
game
down.
Over.
Another one down.
Ah, tiger tongue.
Another one bites the rust. Ooh. Give me a crit. Give me that crit. Damn. Come on. Okay. Let's do a sprint and shoot. Diggs over there. 5% chance to crit there. We should have 15% chance. Yes. Oh, come on. That's not fair. That's not fair! Note I haven't died yet. Last time we died.
You alright, little brother?
Yeah, I'm alright. I'm alright.
Test. Oh, that's crazy. Power's just gone way up.
That
mean you got some new tricks up your sleeve.
Hell yeah. Not enough to break through the wall, but let's go back and tell them.
Oh, the grabbers are back at it again. Come on. Come on. What do we have? So we have, that looks like a skull crusher to me. That's a scout.
More of these assholes.
I'll give them a taste of this new vortex power.
Okay, use Miasma powers in combat to shift the odds in your favor. Miasma powers cost kilowatts. Energy cells can be used to replenish kilowatts. You can edit Miasma powers for characters with the Miasma gloves from the party screen. So again, just like guns, you can edit these powers. We're going to be using the Miasma storm ability, so I'm going to quickly pick up this target, and we are going to move him into this barrel that we have found here. And it's also, it looks like it's going to take out our scout as well, so let's do this. Come on! Okay, so we have a Skull Crusher and two scouts to go. And it looks like Elvis still has 60 kilowatts. So I wonder if I move
that. That all you got?
Ah, oh, damn. I thought I could. Never mind. Okay, I'm gonna quickly. This can take the hits if needs be, and I'm gonna. Ooh, can I get him? Can I get? I can't quite get them in the cones, which is fine. So we'll just go for that, and we'll try and take out the scout. Got a critical hit though. That's good. Scout just took him out. Hot shot, Elvis. Oh boy, thank goodness for that.
My system's shutting down!
Oh goodness me, we should have healed. We definitely should have healed him. Oh, damn it. If a hero is injured in combat, they're no longer able to act for the remainder of the encounter unless they are revived. You can throw a medipod onto an injured hero to revive them, otherwise the injured hero will get up after the combat encounter. Oh, I don't really know if I can get Biggs there. That's the issue. Oh. Oof. I might be able to. Yes, I can.
To the rescue.
Okay, I'm going to get Biggs healed there.
Hey, how you want?
I'm going to heal Elvis with one turn.
Rise and shine.
And then I'm gonna get these pair in a bit of a pickle. And we now have another AP. So I'm just gonna quickly return one AP because I've got a critical hit. Yes. Oh, and we are enraged. Scout's gonna hold D.
Just a flesh wound.
When your heroes kill enemies in combat, they generate rage. When the rage bar is full, the hero's next shot will get a 100% bonus to its critical chance. We get a 100% crit hit. Any value above 100% critical hit will get converted to extra bonus damage. So what we want to do, we're not going to be able to hit that shot, we might be able to here. Oh, 115% chance. Yes, I like this some damage move. I do like some damage, I do. I don't think I'm going to be able to hit. I'm moving now.
I'm right here, dipshit. Come and get me.
I wonder if we can just quickly. There ain't no way. There ain't no way.
Hey you! What you waiting for?
So he's gonna try and hit one of us. He wasn't gonna move that put Overwatch on, that was the issue. Oh, he moved! Well, that's just not very nice. No, he didn't. 53%!
Buckle up! Okay, let's go back and tell the mayor I powered up.
I'll take that. Bloody will. Right, okay, let's continue on to the map. I don't think we've missed any loot. I don't think there's any loot that I need. No, so we'll quickly fast track to Sedentary. Fast travel to Sedentary.
We're back in business. If we can find some more vortexes.
Your glove gets enough power to blast a hole through that miasma wall.
And we find Mama after all these years. Let's talk to the mayor.
That's it. We're understanding. Build up more miasma powers. Power up the glove, blast through the wall. That's the goal, folks. That's the goal.
Danny, we gotta leave town before these things attack.
I'm staying right here. Mayor Mason will know what to do.
Mayor Mason?
Elvis, you get something from that vortex?
My glove's got this new power.
Who rips through frogs like a knife through jelly?
Yeesh.
Well, slap my
That's
job.
A bit good.
Fantastic work, Elvis. But can it get you through the wall?
It bumped up my total power, but we need more vortexes fast.
Ask and ye shall get. I decoded another one of your mama's files. Read here.
To break through a wall most vile, heal the miasma once defiled. Each vortex offers a reward most keen. Your glove is ready. When blue lights turn orange.
Huh. Guess nothing rhymes with orange. Mom and her riddles.
So when my glove's lights change color, we can bust through the wall and find her. But where are the vortexes?
Sadly, she doesn't say. But I bet anything a certain family knows. They know all.
The first family.
Bingo! Give the boy a star! I heard reports of a First Family airship crashed up north in Happy Hills. If you can reach the ship, grab its data drive, then bring it back here.
Hold on. Happy Hills is off limits. Those are your words.
Hear me now and hear me clear. The miasma is more than nasty weather. It's an evil energy that has brought America to its knees. Dividing states once united, poisoning communities, pissing on our values.
Okay, Mayor, okay. We don't have time to wander. We'll get the data drive.
Proud of you, boy.
Okay, Godspeed. So we're gonna head to Happy Hills.
That'll be worth it.
We're gonna head to a place called Happy Hills.
Happy Hills is on the far side of Widow's Mine.
To get to Widow's Mine, we gotta get past the Skywell. Come on.
This is way above our pedigree.
So whilst we do that, let me just check the health of them. They're all fully healed up, whatever we want to call that. However, they do have some skills. So I'm going to quickly just maybe give Elvis a bit of a health boost, and we're going to give Diggs a big bro. Because you never know when we need you to rely on your big bro. So what we're going to do, we're going to quickly head to the next area, and then we shall be calling the stream here, if that is all right with everybody. Obviously, I want to give a massive thank you and shout out to everyone whether or not you've been in the chat, whether or not you've been lurking at home, both over on Twitch or on YouTube, we really appreciate you. Thank you ever so much. As a quick reminder, Miasma Chronicles is live now. It is available digitally on PS5, Xbox Series X, and S, and over on PC. That is Epic, Steam, and GOG. Nice playing, James. Have a great weekend, everyone. You too, Odin. Thank you ever so much, buddy. I really appreciate it. Thanks, Frank.
Should you boys be out here alone?
Look who's talking. What are you, 19?
Something like that. I'm Jade. Gun for hire. And I'm gonna allow you to hire me.
This got nothing to do with you, darling. Go home.
Does the robot talk the whole time, or do you have a say?
Well, thanks for the offer, Jade. But we
work best as a duo.
Yeah? Not anymore. You're on the Grabber's hit list.
Grabbers?
It's what the frogs are called. They've been tracking you since that little dust-up in Gator Zone. And now, down this path in a perfect little kill box, they're fixing to ambush you.
You know about these grabbers?
Yeah, I know a lot. Pretty amazing. You two go in there, zero chance of survival. You go with me, whole different story. You might even learn something.
What do you want in return?
It's who I want. The same who you've been trying to find your whole life, Elvis.
Thing is, Jarhead.
Balmati.
Okay, she doesn't know Jade. You?
He doesn't
know Jade.
And
why are you trying to work my brother?
Diggs, hold on. Balmati's our mother. You know her?
I know the legends. I got a problem with the first family, and I need her help. I'll leave it at that. You get me through that miasma wall to meet Balmati, I'll keep you boys alive along the way. We got a deal?
Can't argue with that. You're in.
Right! We have met a new party member. We have Jade. Jade is a great character. As Jarhead over on Twitch has pointed out, she really is. We shall be continuing our definitive playthrough of Miasma Chronicles next time. Next week, actually, in fact. But folks, so we shall be able to actually go ahead with Jade and show her what she can really do.
The wall's that way.
However, before we do go, we shall be calling the stream here. But before we do go, I'm going to give again a massive thank you, a huge congratulations to everyone involved within Miasma Chronicles. If anyone is still in the UK office and wants to come in, feel free to do so now, and we'll have a jolly good old. Clapperoo, and wait, thank you for everyone else. So please come in, folks, if you are still watching. I'm pretty sure most of you are either gone home or in calls. I can't remember. Regardless, we want to give a massive thank you and shout out to everyone within the community who has embraced Miasma Chronicles, has taken hold of both Elvis and Diggs' story and really seen them for what they are, a journey of discovery for both of them. Miasma Chronicles is out now, folks. It is out now on both PlayStation 5, Xbox Series X and S, Steam, GOG, and Epic Games, and it is absolutely wonderful. Please make sure that you follow everything from 505 Games, whether or not is the Twitter, the Facebook, the Instagram. And more importantly, go follow us over on Twitch, and also for everything else surrounding us as well. But for us over at 505 Games, we want to give a massive thank you and shout out to everyone here. So please, 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 come on. Don't be shy. Never mind. Congratulations. We want to give a massive congrats to everyone over at 505 Games, the bearded ladies, and more importantly, you guys, for an amazing, amazing launch. Thank you ever so much, folks. We shall be seeing you next week. Bye!